In this lecture, we will discuss about the basics of divergence and curl of a vector function. Mathematically, del dot P is a divergence of vector function V, and when del operator operates on a vector function V via dot product, we get a scalar function. Del dot P is equal x cap partial x plus y cap partial y plus z cap partial z is the expression of del dot, and this is the expression of vector V. By taking the dot product between these two expressions, we get partial Vx over partial x plus partial Vy over partial y plus partial Vz over partial z, which is nothing but a scalar. Hence, divergence of a vector function is nothing but a scalar number. Hence, we can say divergence is a scalar function and divergence is applied on a vector function. In words, we can say divergence is a measure of how much the vector V spread out or converge to the point. Divergence can be positive, negative, or zero. For example, the vector function in figure A has a large positive divergence. And in the figure C, the function has arrows pointing inside, so it has a negative divergence. In figure C, the function has zero divergence. Now, let's have a very good example to understand the basics of divergence. And that example consists of a water tank, and we have a tap over here, and we pouring the water inside the tank, and we also have outlet which can be used to drop the water from the tank. Now, at this point of the tank, you can see the water will decrease because water is coming out of the tank, and we have more water at this region because water coming first at this region where the magnitude of the water is always greater than the magnitude of water at this point or this point. And this is the region where you can see the level of the water almost same at all time. So this is how we can say that the divergence at all of these three points are different. So at this point, because water is decreasing, so divergence is decreasing, so hence divergence V is less than zero. At this point, we have more water comparatively to the other points, so we have a greater divergence, so divergence V is always greater than zero. And because we couldn't see any difference at the level of water at this point, so we can say that divergence is zero at this point. I hope this example would be helpful for you to understand the basics of divergence. Let's have a look at this example now, where we have a few functions along with the plots of those functions. For example, here we have a function having a plot in figure A. Here we have a function having plot in figure B. And here we have function have a plot in figure C. Now by taking the divergence of all these three functions, for example, when we take the divergence of the first function, we get 3. And by taking the divergence of the second function, we get 0. And by taking the divergence of the third, we get 1. It means, as far as the first figure is concerned, we have a positive divergence. So whenever we take the divergence of that function, we get 3. It means we have a higher and positive divergence. In the second case, if you look at the figure, the first expression is that there is no divergence. So by taking the divergence of second function, we get 0. And in the third case, as expected, because we can see from the figure that there would be a divergence. So the divergence of the third function, we get 1. Now let's have a look at the basics of curl. Mathematically, del cross V is a curl of V vector. when we operate the del operator on this vector function v, where the cross product, we get a vector function. Del cross v can be written in determinant form, where x cap, y cap, z cap, and the second row consists of the components of del, and the third row consists of the components of vector v. Now, I hope you are familiar with the determinant, so we can simplify this determinant by this way, where you can see x cap into, you multiply these two terms and then take the difference of this term from it, and similarly we use the same technique for this part and this part. So conclusion is, at the end you get a vector quantity. Hence, curl of a vector function always gives a vector quantity. So we can say curl is a vector quantity, and curl is always applied on a vector quantity. In words, we can define now that the curl describes the circulation of a vector field about a point. It means, if you look at these three figures, where you can see that the first expression we get from this figure, we easily can say that there is no curl, and similar answer would be for the second figure, and also the third figure has no any curl. So all of these three figures have zero curl. But if you look at this figure now, you can see that the arrows are rotating around the z axis. So this means there is a curl, and that curl is in z direction. Now, to understand the basics of curl, let's have a look at this figure, where suppose a water is moving in this direction, and we place a turbine at the upper level of the water, and the second time we put the turbine at the lower level of the water. So when, by placing the turbine at the upper layer, turbine starts moving anti-clockwise, and you can expect that the motion of the rotation of the turbine will be faster. And in the second case, when you put the turbine at the lower level of the water, because at the lower level of the water, the motion of the water is very slow. So as a result, turbine will move very slow, or you can say there will be no any motion of the turbine. Hence, from this example, the main message is that curl tells us how much motion is happening. So maximum rotation of turbine at the surface of the water, and minimum motion of the turbine inside the water. I hope this example will help you to understand the concept of curl. Now, let's have at this problem now, where we have two functions along with their plots. In the figure A, you can see that you have arrows rotating around the z-axis, and suppose that this graph belongs to this expression, and the figure B belongs to this expression. So by now taking the curl of both expression, for example, taking the curl of VA, we get 2z, and by taking the curl of vector VB, we get z. So whatever the magnitude of the answer, but if you look at the answer, you can easily predict that the answer is in a vector form, and the vector form showing that the curl in both functions are along the z-axis. So it means that curl is happening in both cases. Dear students, that's all for the today's lecture. Thank you so much for watching. Stay tuned, and please subscribe my channel and share this video with your friends.